First we had Razer touting
the mask of the future.
Now we have Dyson trying to sell us on the same thing. Hi, welcome to Z-Gadget Review. For a while there, it looked like smart masks were the path of the future. Razer came up with their own mask and they made all these promises that turned out not to be 100% true. I made a video on that, which you can see in the description section or up here somewhere. Well, now it seems that air purifiers are all the rage. And the reason is because of allergens in the air, pollution. So companies are trying to look for ways to give you purified air to breathe. One of those companies is Dyson. They have a line of air purifiers that cost an arm and a leg, like most Dyson products do. Now Dyson has decided that, hey, why just keep an air purifier at home? Because yes, you can purify the air in your home, but when you are out there in the streets, all the air that you're breathing might have bad stuff for you. So why don't we make a portable air purifier that you can wear in your face? That is Dyson Zone, which is a portable air purifier that you wear on your face. But the Dyson Zone isn't just an air purifier. It's also headphones. And this is literally a pair of headphones that you're going to wear with a mask in front of it, which they're calling a visor, that goes in front of your nose and mouth. Unlike Razer or other masks, this isn't a mask that is created to protect you from COVID-19 or any other airborne diseases. The idea of this is literally what I've been saying. It's an air purifier. The ear cups on the headphones are going to have filters. These are potassium-enriched carbon filters that are going to go in the ear cups. The ear cups are going to have motors that are constantly working, pulling air from the ear cups and filtering it through the potassium carbon filter. And then the purified air is going to transfer through that visor, aka mask, and the air is going to blow directly to your nose and mouth. Now, this isn't going to cover your nose and mouth, so it's not going to be right on top of your nose and mouth. It's going to be actually in front of it. So it's going to be a small gap in between the visor or mask and your face and mouth. So you're going to have pretty much air being pumped all the time towards your face. It's going to be like having a fan right in front of your nose and mouth. The filters use electrostatic filtration that captures 99% of particles pollution as small as 0.1 micron. The filters also capture city gases like NO2, SO2, and O3. They're using the same type filters that you can find on Dyson air purifying products. Right now, obviously, we don't know how much this is going to cost. But if the filters obviously are going to have to be changed every once in a while, we don't have information on how often either. But if any indication is the pricing of our current filters, which goes between $70 and $80, then that can give you an idea of how much the filters will cost. I'm assuming that they will sell two filters, you know, a pack of two, since it's a headphone device with filters on each cup. The headphones, of course, are going to be wireless headphones. You're going to be able to listen to music and you're also going to be able to make phone calls. My only doubt is about how much will the little motors in those headphones are going to interfere with the sound in the headphones. Because if you have something constantly going there that's pulling air from the environment, then you know, you have to have some sort of noise that might enter the space of the music that you're listening to. The headphones are going to have active noise canceling, which is one of the ways that they might get rid of that engine sound on your ear. And that is going to have three different modes. One is going to be isolation, which is going to give you the highest active noise cancellation, conversation, which activates the moment that you take the visor away from your face in order to be able to speak, which is why it's called conversation. once you do that, the fans are going to stop spinning, the air purification system is going to shut down, and then you're going to be able to have conversations with people, and the noise cancellation, of course, is going to be at its lowest or non-existent at that moment. And then finally, you have transparency. Transparency allows you to listen to environmental sounds in order to hear traffic and things like that if you need to pay attention to your surroundings. The air purifying mask, or visor as I call it, is going to have four different modes, and that's going to be low, medium, high, and auto. So that kind of gives you an idea of what the little motors in the ear cups are going to be doing and how much airflow you're going to be getting out of the mask. They're also going to be selling attachments. So if you want to actually seal off the top and bottom of that to create a mask, then you can do that. The product is slated to ship this fall. As I said earlier, we don't have any pricing yet for it, but it is a Dyson product, so you can expect it to be pretty expensive. Now, when it comes to the sound that the headphones provide, it's supposed to be premium sound. Whatever premium sound means, that's what they're saying that is going to be. But there really isn't much to say about this product until people get it in their hands and they actually are able to test it. Another thing that they're saying is that the visor provides a two-jet way air purification that blows to your nose and mouth, and that the way that the air is purified, air is going to be coming out of those vents, it is going to help it with crosswinds. I think it's pretty cool that people are thinking about the future, right? And the fact that the environment is getting worse as the years go, and the pollutants in the air are getting worse as the years go, and provide solutions for you to have clean air to breathe. It looks cumbersome and weird. It kind of reminds me of the grunts from Halo. It looks like somebody played a lot of Halo and took their design cues from these guys. And that's the first thing I thought of when I saw it. I thought it was funny. I think if you watch the movie Dune, I think that a solution that's closer that goes like in your nose, I guess not necessarily inside your nostrils, will be a lot better and easier to use. But that also can get uncomfortable. And if you have a cold, I guess there's a lot of other factors on why that wouldn't be a great solution. But hey, you know, the fact that these things are exist and they're making things like this is good for the future of humanity, I guess. And I guess leave it to Dyson to have something like this. I guess once this device makes it to market, we'll see if it actually works or is a bunch of BS and it's just a way for Dyson to get headphones into the market. What do you think about this air purifier from Dyson? Do you see yourself wearing something like this? Have you been thinking of anything like this? Have you ever thought about a portable air purifier? Let me know in the comment section. That is it for me. Go ahead and subscribe. Give us a thumbs up. It really helps the channel. Go ahead and hit that bell so you can be alerted every time we have new videos. And thank you very much for watching.